I would like to welcome you all here tonight. This is the Drama Alumni and Friends annual show that we do at Alumni Weekend every year, and we love that you are here to share it with us. We're very excited. For the first time ever, we will be performing the Drama Alumni and Friends with Wackapella, who is an a cappella group who are made up of students, and they're a really fantastic group. We're so excited to be working with them. So let's have a big round of applause for new friends and new collaboration. So I am the chair of the Drama Alumni Steering Committee, and just to give you guys a little information, there's a little note in the program about it. Basically what that is a group of people, dancers, singers, actors, directors, who come together and who are alumni, and they basically want to make sure that we continue to do shows here at the school and to work with the students and to just basically stay a family. That's really important to us. So we are at this time looking for some new members. We have a small group of us has been doing this for about 10 years, and we would love, love, love to just widen our ranks so that we can do more programming. We really, really love what we do. We really love all of the people we've gotten to work with. So if you are interested, and or if I know you and I tackle you later and want to talk to you about it, I apologize in advance. But I'm really excited to just let you guys know more. We have a couple of little just housekeeping things. Phones, please take them out, turn them off. Or at least if you are going to let them ring, have a really interesting ringtone. All right. We have a videographer down front, so if she needs to stand up and move around, please just help her out, give her a little bit of space. We also would like to just talk really quickly about the Honorary Producers Program. It's on the back of your program. It's something where you can actually sponsor a student show here at the Dance and Theater Department. And I've been an honorary producer in the past. That's my picture with Val Dunn, who was a student at the time. She's since graduated. And it's where you can just be really involved in a show that's still on campus. You get to come to a rehearsal. You get to come to lunch or dinner with the director. And it's just an amazing way to not just share, you know, the experience, but also to give them a sense of what it's like after graduation, because there are lots of questions. All right, well, let's get started. We're very excited to have our show tonight. So first I would like to introduce our alumni a cappella group, Keys of Whack.
In the Key of Whack.
Whatever. And please give them a big round of applause.
Soccer or rugby or football. It's just some really mundane activity that they're going to be really hyping up and getting really into. So again, to the suggestion, I need from someone in the audience a mundane activity, something that you do multiple times a week. What was the dishes? Wash the dishes. Okay, wash the dishes. So this is going to be sports announcer, washing the dishes. Take it away.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for tuning in this evening to C-SPAN Especial. I am Hale Thorpe-Winslow, and this is my partner, Richard Tickler. Tonight, we are going to be catching on to the third stage of the 2016 World Open Dishwashing Championships.
It's very exciting.
It is very exciting. Let's go down to our man on the scene.
Hi there.
This is Frank Frankelson.
Yes,
that'll do. And my wife Susan just left me. But it's not about Susan and her heartless ways. It's about washing dishes, which I wouldn't have killed you to do once in a while, Susan. I'm sorry. Here right. we have
some great competitors today. Look at the Hungarian. Look at her form. It's like she's flying.
Hungary, a very strong competitor in the dishwashing field.
Well, and here we have the Swedish contestant who appears to be taking just a moment to relax and get herself focused. But I'm very confused at why she's brought her guide dog with her. It's going to be very, very difficult to watch dishes with her guide dog.
The Swedes are new on the dishwashing scene. They're still sorting out some of the technicalities, but she's really done an impressive job this year getting this far.
I just don't
know. And that is a lovely dog.
I mean, but she's not even blind. That's
licking
the thing
the
that really...
Okay, and the referee is giving the signal to start. Let's see. Neither one has turned on the water yet. A bold decision.
That is gutsy. It's gutsy. Wow! She has abandoned the guide dog. She is licking the plates herself. That is amazing. You never saw that. I don't know. We need to check. Let's check down there. Is it legal? Is this legal?
You know, I had a dog, and Susan took it when she
all did. Right. So,
and here come the glasses. The dirty glasses. Yes, stacked up high. This is one of the most challenging parts of the competition.
The Hungarian. Oh, she has thrown
that
the
is,
cups.
That
oh,
is
I can.
Be a
yeah, I.
Production. I think that's gonna be.
A I don't know. Yep. Her form is.
Why seem to be our Swedish contestant is having palpitations of some sort.
Okay. All right, the Hungarian tried to administer Hungarian
this
CPR. This is Hungarian CPR. You throw cups at her face.
It appears that she got a chicken bone lodged in her
throat.
This is really gonna hurt her chest.
That I wouldn't wish on anyone except for Susan.
But we're not allowed to touch the contestant,
yes.
So it's gonna have to work through this.
You know, this really seems
nothing
like
I
the game dog would come in handy, but it's just sitting there.
And the Hungarian seems concerned, but she is cycling through her place.
That is the competitive spirit.
That is amazing.
That is the beauty.
She's the Michael Jordan of this sport.
And she's almost done. She just needed to get that shit.
Too hasty. Oh, okay, she's definitely dead.
All right.
Well, that's a no decision, isn't
that
it?
That is a no decision. We are going to have to come back tomorrow to settle this. Sorry, you didn't win.
All right, would anyone like to hear the poetry that I've written?
No!
Called questions, and the way that this game works is we're going to have two lines of people that are going to come into a scene, and again we'll get a suggestion in a minute, and the only things that can be said in the scene are questions. So if anyone ever says a statement or they hesitate too long or they say something like that, we're going to yell at them, we're going to go like burp or something like that, something really annoying at them, so that they suffer the consequences. And then we'll move on to the next person. Someone else comes in line and takes their turn after that. So again, back to the suggestion, I need two things from people. First, I need something that someone here learned after they graduated college, something that you learned after being in college. Don't be shy. Not all at once, please. Please, not all at once. How to Live in the City. Thank you very much. And so How to Live in the City. Okay, this might be a little redundant, but can we get a place? Can we get a place that isn't the city? Yes.
Hell's Kitchen, for granted.
Hell's Kitchen. All right, so the major theme that's going on is going to be How to Live in the City and Hell's Kitchen. So questions only, can I get two people to come on up and start us off?
Are you any good at cooking?
Do you know what recipe we're making?
Do you know Gordon Ramsay?
I don't.
Shame.
What are you cooking?
What are you cooking?
Aren't you supposed to?
Does this look well done to you?
Do you think I care?
Do you know what salmonella is?
Do you have a job to be doing?
You guys know Hell's Kitchen isn't a real kitchen,
right? You think you're making a customer?
I thought it was Jack's.
What are you doing? Doesn't it look like I'm making jello shots?
What are jello shots?
Aren't you Gordon Ramsay?
How did you get in here?
Would you believe they let me in the back?
When did you move here?
Why does that matter?
Have you ever lived in the city?
Do I look like I should be talked to by some young whippersnapper like you like that?
Do you know even how to cook?
Do you know how to give me a frying pan and shut your butt up?
Do you know who I am?
Do you know who I am, Sonny?
I don't.
What you doing, old man?
How do you move like that?
How do you keep breathing?
Do you know I find that offensive?
Do you know that you're old as crap and I don't care?
Shouldn't we be cooking?
Why'd you do that?
Don't you know I'm a violent man?
Don't you know I hate the patriarchy?
Did you know that I served in NAM?
Did you know that I hate veterans?
Why is that?
Do you ever feel like everyone in the city wants to kill us?
Yes, I do.
How many of these crab bushels do we have to lift? Maybe you think we need to turn a profit.
All right, great. So this next game is a game that's called Sit, Stand, Lie Down. This game is going to be later. Sorry. Drank a lot before this performance. Bottom of the River, we're going to be doing a song while we do a game called Movie Trailer. And so the way this is going to work is we're going to have Wacapellians in the back, and we are going to be doing a song over and over again. And each time, you have to pretend, imagine that that is the soundtrack to a trailer that you're watching for some movie that's coming out, multiple movies that are coming out. And so for that, we're gonna need two things. One, can I get a movie genre? Just a genre of movies, just yell it out.
Drama.
Drama, I heard drama, thank you. And then what's the title of this movie that we're gonna be seeing all these drama trailers for? What's the title?
What Happened?
What Happened? Sounds good to me. All right, so What Happened, the drama movie, we're gonna be watching some trailers here. Take us away.
Hold my hand. Hoping feels a long way down to the bottom of the river. Hold my hand. Hoping feels a long way down, a long way down. Leaping in the
clock's gonna call in the morning, baby.
Check the cupboard for your daddy's gone.
Red sun rises like a bird.
whenever you guys are ready, we're gonna start from the top.
Actually, we're gonna do a slightly different genre. So we need a new genre.
New genre.
Country western? Is it country
western? Anything else?
And a country western.
Yeah. I've made a comedy in rehearsal. You know what I'm saying?
So, sci-fi and country western sci-fi it is. And what is the title of this country western sci-fi? Aliens descend on Colorado, it is.
Hold my hand, oh baby, it's a long way down the bottom of the river. Hold my hand, oh baby, it's a long way down, a long way down.
Way to go!
Ma'am!
That's so run ahead.
I'm a lifeguard! Don't go in there, ma'am! You're gonna die! There's a shark! There's a lot of sharks!
Wait a minute. Die?
Oh, I gotta get up. Yeah, are you...
At the beach?
Are you coming on to
Who
me?
Who dies at the beach? Is that a dollar?
Hey, that's mine! That's my wallet!
This is tan, I guess.
Ma'am, it's you're tanning. Cool. The sharks are gonna come up and they're gonna get you!
That's...
Hey,
lovely.
No, it's me.
I won't have to pay my student loans.
That's
anymore.
True. I can't argue with that.
Really
no.
Great.
I heard if you look directly at the sun, you can gain its power.
No, you can't. You're gonna hurt yourself. You're gonna blind yourself, and I'll be charged
Wait
with it somehow.
Second. What kind of powers did the sun?
You guys gotta keep thinking about it.
Oh, it's. I don't know. I think I can get a better vantage point
wanna,
down here, but
I wanna see
it helps you to,
wait,
to see. The
ma'am, dark. I swear you're coming on to me. That is the second time.
I am totally looking at the sun. It is
don't,
not.
Don't.
Does anyone else have spots
that.
In front of their eyes?
Your shift's up. It's my turn.
Oh, thank really? God.
Why are you in my way?
I was doing what that guy did.
Oh, I don't understand. It's a lifeguard, not a sun guard. I'm trying to gain some power.
Get out of my stand!
Right? That's what this
Get
does.
Out of my stand!
Have you always been that blurry?
Get out of the stand!
Thank you, I know what
this feels good.
Out.
The sand exfoliates.
I've been staring at the sun all day. What you doing?
Catching some rays, sweetest job ever.
Aren't you like the lifeguard?
Yeah.
There's a guy dead right there.
Yeah, there's not
He's
a lifeguard.
Not in the water.
But it's still like a beach and you're guarding life, right?
I guess I'll just save myself, man.
Oh, thank God.
All right. Thanks for the cool fan.
You okay, man?
No. No, I'm not okay.
She's a terrible lifeguard.
She is a terrible lifeguard.
She's still crazy.
I can't hear you.
Well, that's probably why she's not taking anybody.
Oh.
Should we,
Yeah, let's
get Tsunami! Greatest Hits, and we're actually going to have a couple of the Wackapellians join us. And basically what this is you've all seen the Time Life advertisements late at night where they're selling some set of 50 albums of some people you've never heard of, some obscure music. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to create that album on stage. So what I need from you all is I need a genre of music and a decade. So first, a genre of music. Marching band music.
Let's do it. Yes, and. Yes, and.
Yes, and.
Awesome. It's
now,
on.
It's on. Now we need a decade. 80s. From the 80s.
80s metal?
80s metal marching band?
Yes. 80s metal marching band.
All right. It's away.
Hello, I am beloved cultural icon, the construction worker from the Village People. And I'm here because I just need to get in off the street for a while. Who are you?
I'm the colonial from the Village People.
I don't
you don't remember me? Alright, so... Do you like Sousa? I think we all do. Some days I just want to hear a little... 80s metal Sousa, don't you?
Yes, I absolutely do.
Well, do we have the record for you?
It's a record, right? Yeah.
For do we have the digital download for you? It's Sousa in the 80s metal edition. It's a complete box set of your favorite marches, your favorite 80s metal, mixed together in just perfect harmony.
Does it have that excellent toe tapper cruising in my DeLorean?
It does.
One more time.
Cruising in my DeLorean.
Awesome.
Oh. Oh. I believe that song was... A lovely
Anybody?
Feather boa.
A lovely feather boa.
Oh no, I didn't get the gun off in time. Oh, why me? I will cry out to the world dramatically. Oh, why have you forsaken me?
We hope to see you at all of the future Dramalumni and Friends events. All right, thank you all.